alkyne halide. The hydrohalogenation of alkyne halide. Write down alkyne halide. Alkyne halide goes under dehydrohalogenation reaction, minus of HX. Dehydrohalogenation is removal of hydrogen halide. Alkyne halide goes under dehydrohalogenation reaction in presence of a base. In presence of a base, this reaction follows E1 and E2 elimination. E1 and E2 elimination reaction. See this E1, E2, SN1, SN2, like I said, all these reactions we'll discuss in detail in reaction mechanism. Okay, here I'll give you a bit of idea how this reaction happens. Okay, so first of all, this 2 and this 1 stands for order of the reaction. It is second order elimination reaction. This is first order elimination reaction. Okay, so E2 reaction is possible with 1 degree and 2 degree alkyne halide. Okay, 1 degree and 2 degree. RX alkyne halide, if you have, then E2 reaction possible, and E1 reaction generally possible in tertiary alkyne halide RX in polar solvent.
So for both of them?
What?
For both of them or only?
This is polar solvent. Generally E2 reaction takes place in non-polar solvent.
Okay? So if that was in a non-polar thing, then E1 wouldn't happen.
No, E1 reaction takes place in polar solvent.
So if I then put only a tertiary thing in a non-polar solvent?
We won't take. Okay, so like SN1, SN1 in E1 are similar reaction. Like similar in terms of the number of steps. Like in SN1 also, we'll have an intermediate carbocation. Two-step reaction, carbocation forms and nucleophile attacks. Here what happens, again carbocation forms and then H plus eliminates from this. That's why it is elimination reaction. Okay, so it is similar to SN1 in terms of the number of steps involved or the intermediate forms. Correct. So it is also two-step reaction. SN1 is substitution of nucleophile, and this one is elimination. So product is completely different. This is one-step reaction. Okay, these two, three things we must remember. Now we'll see the reaction here. Suppose we have a compound alkyne halide, say carbon halogen, and here we have hydrogen present. Okay, now for this reaction we use a base. Base can be small base also. We can use like C2H5O-. Okay, we can also use some bulky base. In presence of bulky base, the product is different. For small base, the product is different. Okay, we'll see what product we get. But in general, the steps of the reaction is this base extracts H plus from the beta carbon. Okay, what is beta carbon here? The one which has hydrogen, right? The halogen which attached with the carbon atom, that carbon is alpha carbon, right? So this carbon is alpha and this carbon is beta. This base B- extracts H plus from the beta carbon, right? And this bond pair of electron, it comes over here and it comes down here to make a pi bond. This halogen atom goes out as leaving group as X-. Okay, so overall what happens? The product of the reaction is we have C double bond, C plus halide ion goes out, and the conjugate acid of this base forms pH.
So is this bulky or small?
It's a general step of the reaction. We'll see what is the bulky base, what is the small base.
Okay. So this is.
But in general, no, it is a E2 reaction. It's E2 reaction. It's one step reaction. So in general, the reaction takes place like this one. So the base takes H plus ion from the beta carbon, and this bond pair forms pi bond here, and then halogen atom goes. Now write down base. Used for this reaction.
So why is it called E2? Like
because it is second order elimination reaction. The order of this reaction based on this and this. Base, the concentration of base and the reagent, alkaline. That's why it is second order. Okay? Don't ask me what is order. Order we are studying in chemical kinetics. Okay? Just you understand the second order elimination reaction. Okay? Order we'll discuss in chemical kinetics. Okay, right on. Base used for this reaction. The first point to write down, if we use a small base like, ethoxide ion or hydroxide ion.
Ethoxide is
2C. C2H5O-. If we use a small base like ethoxide ion, C2H5O-, or hydroxide ion OH minus, then the product, then the major product is the SAYTZEFF product. SAYTZEFF. C2H5O minus and OH minus. Hydroxide ion and ethoxide ion.
Second, repeat that.
If you use a small base like ethoxide ion or hydroxide ion, then the major product of the reaction will be, according to the SAYTZEFF rule, or we can also say it as SAYTZEFF product. Okay. SAYTZEFF is SAYTZEFF. SAYTZEFF product, the major product, or we also call it as ZSAFE. Both are the same thing. Basically, we'll get more substituted alkene. This means we'll get more substituted alkene. More substituted alkene. Okay, is the major product. I'll show you one reaction. Carry first you write down, we'll discuss with example. Okay. Next you write down, if we use a bulky base, like tertiary butoxide we write like this. T stands for tertiary, BuO-, tertiary butoxide ion.
What's the structure of that?
CH3 whole thrice CO-, CO-, and 3 CH3 group attachment. Tertiary butoxide ion, triethyl amine. All these are large base.
So what
are bulky base? Bulky means size bada hoga. Okay, that is it. Bulky. Okay, triethyl amine. Triethyl amine. Etc. Then the major product of the reaction is Hoffman product. Hoffman product. Okay, what is Hoffman product? Less substituted alkene. Reason also we'll see. But you see the reaction. Okay, suppose the alkyl halide is this CH3CH2 CBr CH3 and CH3. And in the reaction we are using a base, say C2H5O-. This is the base we are using. They can also give you C2H5O and Na like this, salt of this alcohol. Same thing here, Na plus and this minus. So this also behaves the same thing. Now one thing is here, this reaction takes place in a solvent, right? So whatever base you are taking here, the conjugate acid of this will take the solvent. So what is the conjugate acid of this? H5OH. Just we add H plus into this, okay? Suppose we are taking OH minus as a base. Then the solvent is what? H2. This is the condition we have. We always take the conjugate acid as a solvent. Right? So this is the reagent for this reaction. Now the product in this, can you tell me the product? Product will be CH3, CH double bond, CH3 plus we also get CH3 CH2 C double bond CH2 CH3. This is the two product we get. Okay, what is this product? This is set zip product, more substituted alkene, right? And this is Hoffman, Sedgef and Hoffman. Okay, how this reaction proceeds? See, this is the base we have, right? This base takes H plus ion from the beta carbon. What is the beta carbon here? This one is alpha, this one is beta, and this one is also beta, even this one is also beta. However, these two positions are same position, right? Yeah. If you take H plus from here or here, you'll get the same product, okay? So the possibility is what? That this base, C2H5O- attacks onto this hydrogen, takes H plus, this bond pair comes over here, and this Br goes out as a leaving group Br minus. Product is Sedgef product. This is path A supposedly. So Sedgef we get with path A. Now if this base also so this is the base. When it attacks onto this hydrogen, this is also the possibility, right? This is path B. So with this the product is what? Hoffman product. So the point is, this base has tendency to extract this hydrogen and this hydrogen. The major product depends upon the stability of alkene. We know more substituted alkene is more stable. That's why this is the major product, Sedgef product. Okay, so what I said that this base takes H plus from the beta carbon. It always attacks onto the beta carbon, right? So this H plus is taken up by this base and this bond pair of electron, it comes over here to form a pi bond, right? When it comes over here, so this carbon has to lose one bond so that it completes tetravalency, right? So this Br minus, we know halide ions are good leaving group, right? So this Br takes this bond pair of electron and goes out as Br minus leaving group, and we'll get this alkene. Okay?
Does this work with fluorine also?
Fluorine generally we don't use because the bond strength of carbon fluorine bond is very strong. Okay? In that case, we'll get a different product. Have we discussed calling this? But the fluorine case, the things will be different. Generally, Hoffman product is favorable there.
So how big does a base have to be for us to call it bulk?
That you don't have to think about. You just have to think this. C2H5OH is a smaller base. OH minus ion is a smaller base. In fact, CH3O minus is also a smaller base. When you have a large base, it will be some branch will be there. Tertiary group attached over. This is, I mean, triethylamine, right? Triethylamine, kya ho gaya? N ke saath. 3 ethyl group attached. So when you look at this group, it looks like bulky group, right? This is ye nahi hai parameter. There is no parameter of this. Ye size ke baad bhi consider the bulkiness of that group. But when you do some questions, when you solve some questions, you understand which one is bulky, which one is not bulky. Like the example that I have given, mostly you'll get this tertiary butoxide ion, TBuO-. The same thing will be written in the question also. Okay? Or suppose some tertiary alcohol is there. CH3 and OH. That is bulky. But tertiary group we consider as a bulky base. So this is Sedgef, stable, Hoffman, the minor product of this. Sometimes again I'm telling you, across this double bond, GI is possible if these two groups are different. Suppose I have C2H5 kar deta hu, so this becomes C2H5 and CH3. It means across this geometrical isomerism possible, so this copy cis or trans, two product will be possible then. Right?
Both of the equally.
Yes, equally formed. This will be major, but in this, we consider two products, not one. Okay? So if they ask you number of products, okay? So whenever alkene is forming, always consider this geometrical isomerism condition. Okay? Next one you write down, next point.
So why do we take C2H5O? How does it help in this?
See, any reaction takes place in the solvent. The molecules are moving, right? And in this way only this ion will attack onto this H+.
So why it doesn't need C2H5OH?
Generally, see, you can use another solvent also.
Yeah.
But the point is, we require a proper rate of the reaction. So in, even if you see in physical chemistry, you have an a concept called electrode potential. So electrode potential mein kya hota hai? Electrode ko, this is a metal rod. Suppose a zinc metal rod, right? So this will dip into a solution which is which has the same ion present in this. So the condition is what? If you have zinc electrode, this will always dip into ZnSO4. Then only you'll get half cell. Okay. So point is, there are many conditions. You can take another solvent also there. But in that case, the reaction is not that feasible. It's difficult to proceed with the reaction. So maybe if you use some other solvent, so the mobility of this ion is affected in that solvent. Okay. And it is, you are getting this from this only. This is not getting reacted into the, getting consumed in the reaction. So when this H plus comes out, you see, with this C2H5OH minus, O minus, you'll get H5OH and Br minus goes out. So this is not getting consumed in the reaction. If it is different, then you'll get some different product. The rate of the reaction, many things will be there, gets affected. And since, and that is why we are not using different solvent. Another way what you can say, that this base, you are getting from this solvent only. This will dissociate like what? C2H5O minus. And that C2H5O minus will attack. So for any, even if you see, if you take another, I will discuss that example also. Solvent, if you take water, what, why we cannot take water here? Because if you take water, so water, in water, oxygen also has two lone pair, right? So water also behaves as a nucleophile. So there is possibility that this lone pair also attacks onto this hydrogen. That is also the possibility, right? To minimize that fact also, we are using the solvent of this conjugate acid base pair. Okay.
So but you told for OH minus H2 is a solvent.
Ah, that's what he said. What? Okay. Why we cannot use another solvent here? Suppose we use water, then this may also attack onto this. That's why we are not using. Preferably what we use, that it is a given condition. Preferably is what? Base and its conjugate acid as a solvent. That is the ideal condition for this kind of thing. Even in organic chemistry, this thing is true in all the chapters.